One week before the Hamid Lawal fight, Irishman Steve Collins was putting his WBO super middleweight title on the line against Burton's Neville Brown. Brown had a respectable 29 wins in 32 fights, Collins 31 wins out of 34.
Third defence of the title is for Steve Collins, and he still hopes for a big money fight with Nigel Benn if Benn doesn't retire. Neville Brown, the challenger from Burton-on-Trent in Staffordshire, the British middleweight champion, moving into world class in the black and white stripes. He's a top class, world class amateur, Brown, and very unlucky indeed not to fight in the Olympics. But the usual rugged aggression from Collins, and Brown getting into some good looking head punches and looking sharp there.
Yes, that's what he's got to do. Collins is going to storm in here. When he does that in recent fights, he's looked ungainly and missed widely. So really, this is where the boxing of Neville Brown has got to come into play. He's got a sharp retry and counter. Sharp, Brown.
Collins is among the most resilient of fighters, as I've said. He's never been stopped, but don't underestimate Brown's punch power. That could be a factor a few people haven't considered in this fight. Trying to present, it's clear already, Collins with a mobile target. Oh, it's a right hand from Collins, and Brown is down in the first round, chopping middle right to the head. He's up quickly, will get a mandatory count, and he winks across the ring at Collins as if to say, decent shot. But Brown in trouble in round one. Collins promised us he'd be a lot sharper tonight than he was last time against Cornelius Carr. And that is exactly the kind of psychological edge that he was looking to establish straight away.
Yes, he's been very aggressive and carrying forward with the big punches. He's trying to out-psych and really out-hustle Brown in the ring.
Does that mean that Brown, moving up to super middleweight, is feeling the weight of a full-blown super middle's punches already in there?
It could be. He really just has to keep a clean mind. He's got to concentrate on his own job.
From Collins, exactly the tactics that retired Chris Eubank. There was some talk that he might revert to his old counter-punching style, but not much evidence of that early on here. Right hand from Brown, decent shot. A good start for the champion. Brown doesn't seem too badly shaken up since the knockdown.
He doesn't seem too forced out of it.
And that's a big round for Collins. Steve Collins has had his man down in the first round in this world title defence.
Yes, just a choppy little punch on the top of the head. I think Brown was a little bit off balance. I don't think he was too badly hurt. You see, just right on the top of the head.
Corners, 10 seconds.
Right two. Collins is by a 2-point margin, 10-8. Round two, due to go 12, of course. And again, he's on the run, almost went down again there. Looks as if he did touch down to me. Yes, he did. Brown is complaining, but he has to get a mandatory 8 count. He touched down. Only briefly, but the referee got that right. And Collins here is pulling him and using his strength as the natural super middleweight against the man who's moving up into this division for the first time.
Yes, and nothing really is going right for Brown at this point. He needs to land a good punch, he needs to get a bit of confidence.
Good right hand. Brown put up a superlative effort last time in the defence of his British middleweight title against Sean Cummins, but he's in trouble here early on. He's being pulled around by Collins. He just looks much more stronger. And very, very hungry as well. He's crawling him. And Brown will do well to get out of this hole. Caught by a right uppercut inside, I think, as well. Brown there boxing skills on the outside. This is what he started off in the fight doing.
He needs to get a little bit of room to get his punches off. This close fight like this is suiting Collins' extra strength.
Brown winked in his corner then, as if to say, I'm okay, don't worry about me. He's throwing plenty of his own. Collins tees off with a left hook this time. Looking marked already around the face, Neville Brown.
Good right hand counter from Brown there.
Been an explosive start to the contest. Brown again. Tapped by a right hand. He's kind of just skidded off. He rode it quite well. Just occasionally, as Glenn was saying, just producing his own quite telling counter, Neville Brown. But it certainly not having the same effect as Collins' punches.
This is really a tremendous pace that Collins setting. How long can he keep this sort of workout going? He's really going for a stoppage here.
Big right hand again from Collins, got through to the side of Brown's head. Brown hasn't been elusive enough so far. He's been dragged into Collins' kind of fight. And he wants to trade with him. And remember, I'll say it again, Collins has never been stopped, so really the way to go about beating him is to try to do it and outbox him maybe over the 12 rounds. You would think. Just a bit unsteady on his legs, he seems, Brown as well. Neville Brown here has been down in both rounds, and he's in a critical phase of the fight. He must get through this opening period, you think?
Yes, I think if he gets through this phase, he'll do all right, but it's a very hard part of the fight for him here. He's unlucky to go down there. He just caught it on the end of that punch.
But he definitely touched down.
And he touched down, so probably again a 10-8 round.
Round three. Can Brown get a foothold? He needs to start working, you'd feel, wouldn't you, Glenn, behind that jab. Come up with a bit more lateral movement and ask Collins some more questions. Collins at the moment is just able to walk in and tee off.
Yes, he seems ready to stand and have a fight with Collins. But you would feel that the best thing he can do is use movement, try and pick Collins off.
Evolved into a brawler, really.
That's right, his style, yes, when he was pretty much a boxer and a counterpuncher, become a real brawler.
But his work rate and his intensity is very impressive. He just hasn't let Brown settle. Maybe he thought that the man in his first world title fight would freeze and he would try to pounce on him early. That's worked quite well for him. He has on the scorecards, but Brown is still there.
Yes, he's still there. Every now and again he lands with good counters, Brown.
Blood from the nose of Collins. Nothing much to worry him. Collins. Ooh, the hits seem to come dangerously close together there after the jab by Brown. assists by Collins so far. Brown just hasn't been allowed to settle. The corner have told Brown, I understand, for one round, just try to stay away from him. He wrestles Collins to the floor there. And we'll get a little warning.
Really, he's got to obey the corner, he's got to try and get back to some boxing. Just let himself settle into this fight a little bit. Good jab there, Neville Brown.
Oh, that's a really good right hand from Neville Brown. His best punch so far, really landing cleanly. Collins can really absorb a punch, and there's another one. You just wonder whether Brown may get a second wind in the fight.
Yeah, he's done everything possible in training. He'll be in great condition for this fight. And he's going to have to be, because it's such a physical fight, a very demanding test.
Brown just using his jab a wee bit more than he needs to. And kind of switching to southpaw a moment to throw the right hand. He just has to hope, I think, too, that the Collins fire burns out a little. He's got him in reverse gear though. Forced back windows for the first time, Collins. This is Brown's best round so far.
Has he just given himself a little bit more room in this round? I think Collins is just maybe a little tired as well. He's set an unbelievable pace in the other rounds.
Such an unbelievable pace. Do you think that it possibly could have punched himself out or not?
I think it's still a bit early. He'll get a second win. There's still a lot left in him, but obviously it was a lot to do so early. I think he was going for the stoppage earlier. That hasn't come off. Now he's going to have to rethink his plan.
Well, left from Collins is a punch which really sent the head spinning of Brown.
Brown has had to take some very good Collins punches here. So far, he's stood up to everything.
Collins on the reverse, there in the corner. This is turning into a really grueling battle of almost trench warfare between these two. It has the makings, and only the makings, it's at the moment, of maybe turning out to be something quite memorable. In pace, but no doubt about it, Brown's best round so far, switching styles momentarily, and I think he nicked that round, Brown. The WBO super middleweight title fight, Neville Brown the challenger in the black and white stripes, down in the first two rounds, but having a better round in the fourth there against Steve Collins. Has Brown, you wonder, just weathered Collins' initial blitz?
Off a little bit, and that's suiting Brown because now he's got a little bit more room to work and get his boxing goals.
Oh, getting a little bit ragged as they almost fall around the ring, the two of them there. By the way, Steve Collins tonight, for the first time in a while, does not have his mind doctor, Tony Quinn, with him. They seem to have temporarily company. I don't know if that's a permanent thing. Maybe they'll get back together. How much has Brown got left after taking so much punishment in the first two and a half, 3 rounds?
Both men land there with good punches.
It's a much more even contest now, though.
Yes, Collins gets up with a few good ones, and Brown comes back with good ones of his own.
Cut by the right eye of Brown. A problem, blood flowing by the side of the eye. At the moment, it doesn't look to be flowing into it. And he was cut in his last fight as well. But he came through that and won against Sean Cummins. This is a much stiffer test, a much higher level against Collins.
Good punches inside from Collins there, but Brown again comes back.
Oh, all right. Well, at least should give the corner a chance to work on it, I would think, between the rounds. Collins redoubles his efforts to force the stoppage. Big right hand nail, Brown with his back to the ropes. Collins has picked it up again. It is Nick Brown.
Yes, Collins knows that Brown's cutting. He must be thinking how he can put a good bit of pressure here that will force an intervention.
Neville Brown is finding it hot. His first attempt to become a world champion at the age of 30.
Don't get the deep breathers, I'm talking to you. The eye's all right.
The eye's all right, says Brendan to Neville Brown. Don't worry about it.
Yes, he's going to say that. It didn't look bad when we got a close look. It didn't look good. The doctor's let him go on for the time. He's having a better look at it now, the doctor.
The doctor takes him as well. Seems to be happy. That's how we think the cut happened. Was it a punch or a clash of heads? The referee has certainly made no indication to the judges that he thought it was a clash of heads. So you have to presume it was a punch, but was it?
They were very dangerously close. It looked like a clash there. Certainly they came together. Yes, I think that was it.
Round six. Tartan trunks, as always. His lucky shorts. He's winning the fight at the moment, no question about it. Neville Brown will have to produce a superlative effort. Let McCrory's scorecard will underline how far Collins is in front. 2-10-8 rounds to the Gibbard with the knockdowns. There's a massive task now for Neville Brown to pull this back somehow.
He's just changing his tactics a little bit now. Now he's standing up, looking to jab and box. I think he just wants a little respite. He's worked very hard at the beginning of this fight.
Okay, big shot from Collins. Is he at super middleweight? A very, very hard fight. It's better for Brown using his boxing skills. He's made him a world-class amateur with those nice left jabs, but really, in all honesty, what's going on in there is a long, long way away from the amateur game.
Yes, very much so. Collins just eased off the gas a little bit, not allowing Brown to use his good boxing skills. This sort of fight suits Brown.
Collins, 31 years of age, it's taken him so long, and he's had so much hardship on his way through to the top. Now he's got there. Whoever wins his title is going to have to rip it away from him. He wants the big paydays that still may be out there for him. Maybe against Ben, who knows, against Eubank, if he gets back. Superboy Malinga wants a taste of the action. They're all fights in which he can earn. The crowd has come through so many rough patches here, and give him credit. He's still in there, he's having one of his better rounds in there at the moment. Was until Collins ran it with that heavy right hand.
Good solid right hand. He's got some very solid punches, Brown. Again, his boxing just dropped off a little bit, Brown. He started the round well, but dropped off towards the end.
against Neville Brown.
Good right hand there and the left hook. Just when Brown looked as if he's trying to get his boxing going, he comes storming back Collins.
You'd like to see Brown work behind his jab more, throw it more to try to keep Collins off balance on the way in, wouldn't you, from his point of view? He just hasn't looked really defensively tight enough among other
people. He should have tried to be a little bit more elusive and catch the Collins, but he hasn't done that. He's stood in front of Collins.
It has to be said that Brown is fighting Collins' kind of fight in there at the moment. Give Steve Collins some credit as well. Collins is making him fight it.
Yes, he hasn't really given Neville Brown a chance. He's forced the pace throughout.
You do feel that Collins' much, much greater experience at this level has been a factor here as well, as he lands with another jolting right uppercut. Still, Brown wants to trade with him. And you sense that that's a game he probably can't win.
Yes, it is a lot. He's a much more focused Collins. He's a lot better in this fight than he was in his last fight. He's really up for this one.
Been training in Jersey, normally prepares in Los Angeles, but didn't fancy the jet lag of traveling over a week or so before the fight. Sharper performances by Collins. He doesn't seem too bad, Neville Brown's. The corner have done a decent job. Neither of them finding the other particularly hard to hit.
Not a great deal of defence from either man.
Breathing heavily, Brown. You wonder at what point this non-stop aggression and this heavy handed punching of Collins just might start to really wear Brown down. Brown's colleagues, led by Clifton Mitchell, the British heavyweight title contender, just behind his corner, trying to lift him. Collins shows no signs of letting up there.
Good punches in close from Collins. He just keeps pushing the fight, forcing it on, using his strength.
1-2-3. It's better for Brown. Looks much better when he starts to use the jab and move. Forward again, and he's winning this fight big at the moment, Steve Collins.
Yes, you hear Brendan in the corner. They're saying, make him miss the counter. They know what sort of fight he should fight. Just Steve Collins keeps drawing him into a bruising battle.
Now, are we going to see Brown try to use jab and move tactics? Collins will try to cut him off on the corners if he does that.
Neville Brown. Good work again from Collins in close, using the uppercut in the right hand.
Turn him, Neville, fight the elbow. Turn the elbow, Neville, up the middle.
Collins, as we thought going into this, looks, doesn't he, the stronger man, the natural super middleweight.
He nice physically. He sees the strong. Every now and again, Brown turns and comes back with good punches himself.
He just can't seem to wobble Collins. When he does get through, the punches seem to bounce off Collins. And when Collins lands, his punches seem to be having a real effect.
Yes, he seems to be the stronger and the harder puncher of the two.
In, followed in with the elbow, tried to rough Collins up playing at his own game. Chance of Steve-O.
Credit to Brown, I don't think he's ever had to show as much guts as this. Showing real character on his own. Tremendously hard fight.
Never mind the Brown telling me it took him a whole year to make the graduation from middleweight up to super middleweight. In an ideal world, Brown would have wanted a couple of fights at the new weight before going in this deep. When opportunities arise, they have to be taken, I guess. Breathing very heavily, Brown, and increasingly it looks to be a lost cause for him. What do you think?
Yes, I would agree at this stage. It's been very heavy work for Brown. Was he just pushed off balance there?
No count, no knockdown. As the bell goes to him around Brown, gives Collins an old-fashioned look, but Collins is right on top. Collins, despite all this snarling aggression you see on fight nights, is a very nice man to know. Chatty. He's a guy who's paid his dues in boxing, isn't he?
Yes, he has. He's been a good, honest fighter. Did very well indeed. He deserved this chance.
Right nine.
He believes that a champion has to stay angry and hungry. And he's brought that mentality to the ring. This is a much, much better performance than what he described as a lackadaisical one last time out against Cornelius Carr. And he said he was just a bit burnt out after a tough year. That's understandable enough. And before his scorecard showing Collins in such a lead that Brown already needs the knockout by the look of it. He needs to do what no man has done before and stop Steve Collins. Looking open, the gloves have gone down, maybe ominously for Brown.
Yes, he's obviously very, very tired, struggling to get his hands up there as he was forced back against the ropes.
Brown showing a good deal of bravery and pride. He's going to go down in the world title fight. He's obviously made up his mind that he's going to be in there pitching right to the end if he can.
Brown needed something special in his last fight against Sean Collins, and he did that. He's going to have something special again tonight, I feel.
Who's had fights
in middleweight and is strong in that division. Of course, it makes it got to make a difference.
And it has. Emphatically. Brown lunging forward. And it's another round for Steve Collins. And Barry McGuigan is watching with us as well. Barry, this is beginning to look a bit of a hopeless cause for Neville Brown.
Yeah, and I think, Ian, it is at this stage. I think he looks extremely tired. He tried his best, but Steve Collins has a fabulous knack of making you fight his type of fight. And that's what he done in this fight. And he just completely dominated. Got off to a tremendous start, knocked down in the first, knocked down, sort of suspicious knocked down in the second, nevertheless, a 2-point margin in each round. And really, he just ground this kid down. What courage from them. A fabulous performance. And you know, he can go home with his head high. But, you know, he's losing this big. And you never know. Collins might be able to force a stop before the end.
Thanks, Barry. Three rounds to go.
Look at the punches that he's taking there.
Well, in the corner, Brendan Ingle is saying to Neville Brown, you've got two rounds to stop him. And really, chances of that, quite honestly, about as high as me riding a Cheltenham Gold Cup winner come Thursday. You never know, I guess, that Brown has been a puncher at middleweight, but so far tonight, he has landed some good punches, but they just can't stop Collins, who's putting up some performance here, isn't he, himself?
It's an unbelievable performance to come out to throw barrels of punches like this in the 11th round. His training must have been superb.
He promised us that he would be back to his very best tonight, and he's been as good as his word, Steve Collins.
He's certainly living up to the nickname of the Celtic Warrior.
Ladies and gentlemen, after 54 seconds of round 11, the referee has stopped the contest. The winner, and still WBO super middleweight champion of the world, the Celtic Warrior, Steve Collins.
Good sportsmanship for them.
Ladies
and
gentlemen,
and no doubting the authority of Steve Collins' performance tonight from the first bell right to the time of this stoppage in the 11th round. It's maximum marks for bravery for Neville Brown. Excellent performance from Collins, but one has to ask the question, did it not all go on just a little too long here? Still, the favourite Collins retains his crown. Brown emerges with honour.
Brown had given a good account of himself, but Collins had comfortably outthought and outboxed the British champion. Collins would go on to defend his crown four more times before retiring in 1997.